The age of revolution dawned upon the nation when Indians revolted against the tyrant Britishers and the Tiranga swayed proudly over the nation. Millions of Indians, obsessed by the thought of freedom, freedom from ignorance, freedom from poverty, freedom from illiteracy, and overcoming the barriers of caste, creed, and religion, the Tiranga harnesses Indianness from all quarters. It symbolizes a fine blend of peace, prosperity, and courage. The children of free India, who brought pride to their motherland through their glorious achievements, stand for the whole nation and personify the Tiranga with their selfless service. Marshall, a small village in Goa. It was in this village that scientist Padma Bhushan Dr. Raghunath Anant Marshelkar was born on January 1, 1943. Raghunath lost his father at the age of 5. Anjanitai Marshelkar came to Mumbai to earn a livelihood and raise her son. Mumbai, the commercial capital of the nation, where persons from all over the nation mingle as one. Girgaon is one place in the whole Mumbai where many middle-class families found heaven. In a chawl in the Deshmukh Lane, Khetwadi, there lived two migrant families, of which one was the Marshelkar family, consisting of Anjanitai and her son. The times were indeed tough. Young Raghunath used to go to a municipal school barefooted. In his school, Marshelkar was the most brilliant student and stood first throughout.
आम्ही तिकडे डॉक्टर देशमुख गल्ली समोर खेतवाडीत गल्ली समोरच्या वेडिंगीत राहत होतो. त्यावेळी परिस्थिती फारच कठीण होती आणि ती सातवी झाल्यानंतर मग त्याला युनियन हायस्कूलमध्ये हे करायचं ॲडमिशन मिळवायचं पण तेव्हा माझी परिस्थिती एवढी कठीण होती की तिकडे 21 रुपये फी भरायची होती पण ते सुद्धा माझ्याकडे नव्हते.
माझं लहानपण मला आठवतं. आम्ही फार गरीब होतो ही गोष्ट खरी आहे पण आईने अधिक असं भासू दिलं नाही की आपण गरीब आहोत म्हणून. गरिबी एवढी होती की दिवसाला 2 वेळा जेवायची मुश्किल होती. एवढे त्यावेळी हाल होते की मला अजून आठवतं की मी म्युनिसिपल शाळेमध्ये त्यावेळी जात असे महानगरपालिकेच्या आणि त्यावेळी शनिवारी 3 पैसे एक ज्याला आपण उत्तरपत्रिका म्हणतो ती घेण्यासाठी आमच्याकडे नव्हते. जेव्हा मी 7वी पास झालो आणि 8वीत जायचं होतं त्यावेळी आम्हाला 21 रुपये शाळेची फी जमा करण्यासाठी जवळजवळ 3-4 आठवडे लागले.
त्या काळात म्हणजे 21 रुपये मी फारच कठीण होते माझ्या परिस्थितीमुळे. म्युनिसिपॅलिटी शाळेत पण त्याने कधी पहिला नंबर सोडला नाही आणि नंतर इंडियन हायस्कूलमध्ये पण पहिला नंबर यायचा.
जेव्हा माशेलकर आमच्या शाळेत होता ना तेव्हा तो अत्यंत हुशार विद्यार्थी म्हणून नावाजला. तो आपले पेपर्स इतके उत्तम लिही, सगळी उत्तरं इतकी मुद्देसूद असत की केव्हा केव्हा मला शंका वाटायची की या प्रश्नाचं उत्तर मीसुद्धा इतकं चांगलं लिहू शकलो नसतं. बरं, एकंदर त्याची ती लिहिण्याची पद्धत इतकी चांगली होती की मी केवळ परीक्षक म्हणूनच हातात लाल पेन्सिल घेऊन बसलेला असायचो पण त्या पेपरावर लाल पेन्सिल लावताना माझा हात जरा थरथरायचा.
The experiment of the convex lenses bore fruit as the experienced eyes of the veteran teacher Narhar Bhave recognized the unmatched intellect and wisdom of this meritorious student. My boy, if you want to rise higher in life, you must learn to converge your energies just like a convex lens converges the solar energy, said Bhave sir. It was then that young Raghunath resolved to become a scientist. Raghunath stood 11th in the board. Girgaon Chupaki, where he spent whole nights studying under a street light.
त्या दहावीची परीक्षा त्याने चौपाटीवर अभ्यास करून परीक्षा दिली आणि तेव्हा तो 11वा आला. मला त्याची 100% खात्री होती मी आपली गच्चीत त्याची वाट बघत उभी राहायची.
तिथे गिरगावात उभा राहिलो की वेगवेगळ्या स्मृती येतात, वेगवेगळ्या आठवणी येतात. युनियन हायस्कूलची आठवण येते. गिरगाव चौपाटीवर जिथे मी दिव्याखाली अभ्यास करत असे त्याची आठवण येते. मॅजेस्टिक बुक स्टॉलची आठवण येते कोठावळ्यांची, कारण त्यावेळी गरिबी एवढी होती की पुस्तकं विकत घ्यायची ताकद नव्हती. त्यामुळे नवीन पुस्तक आलं की त्यांना मी सांगत असे की मी तिथे फुटपाथवर बसून वाचेन, पण मला वाचायला द्या.
Despite securing 11th rank in the board examination, Mashelkar had decided to give up further education due to their dire position. He could join Jai Hind College with the backing of Sir Dorabji Tata scholarship and the funds collected by his friends. He ranked second in the merit list at his inter-science examination.
As far as his studies or his career was concerned, while he was in Jai Hind, one really feels very happy that even after 40 years, four decades, he remembers the names of all the professors, including their subjects that he narrates. His stay in Jai Hind from 1960 to 1962, very recently on 28th of February 2003, which was a function to felicitate him as the most distinguished alumnus of Jai Hind College.
Which stream to choose? Wandering at a bus stop, he met his friend Arun Dravid.
And he explained to me what chemical engineering is all about. His father was an IAS officer, ICS officer to be more precise. And he was able to explain to me as to what chemical engineering would be. Because in the 60s, chemical industry was just growing up, so as to say. And the future of chemical industry, petrochemical industry, petroleum industry, was considered to be very bright. And I practically got admission in UDCT, University Department of Chemical Technology, almost on the last day.
Having acquired a degree of chemical engineering from UDCT, in keeping with his mother's wishes to pursue higher education, he sought guidance from Professor M.M. Sharma for his doctorate.
Raghunath Anand Mashelkar, was popularly called Ramesh Mashelkar, was my undergraduate student during the period 1964 to 1966. After graduation, he showed an inclination to do post-graduation and research. Being a very bright student, it was more than a pleasure for me to have him. What is very important to know that he could have easily gone overseas with full fellowship, and an amount that he would have got would have also enabled him to send some money to his dear mother.
Because I had worked with Professor Sharma, who was my guru, on what is called as a mass transfer with reaction.
He came out extraordinarily well, therefore he changed over to PhD. So much so that having joined for research in July 1966, in September 1969, barely 3 years, just over 3 years, he had finished his PhD. His work was so good that it earned him a Leverhulme Fellowship to go to University of Salford. And the only thing I told him at that time, that you should now work in an area unrelated to what you have done for your PhD work.
There was a subject called non-Newtonian fluid mechanics, a very complicated study of matter, which is rather complex. I took up that challenge.
At Salford University, Doctor began his research on rheology, despite the fact that the subject was totally unknown to him. He has always accepted challenges and turned out to be a winner. In spite of the fact that rheology was a new subject to him, he decided to take it up. Within no time, Dr. Mashelkar came to be known as a talented Indian research scientist. One morning in 1975,
Dr. B.D. Tirak, who was then the director of National Chemical Laboratory, in which he simply said that I should go to London and meet Dr. Naidumma, who was then the Director General of CSIR. He did not say as to why I should go and see him, but he was my guru, and you listen to gurus, you know. So I said, I'll go and meet him. And when I met Dr. Naidumma, within half an hour, he explained to me what the future of India, Indian science is going to be. And he said, you know, bright people have left India and they need to come back in order to build a future India. And he invited me to sort of come. And I still remember, I was so charmed and so charged by what he said that I said, yes, we'll go back. In fact, I didn't consult my wife, I must tell you. In the evening, I phoned her up in Manchester and I said, the nation is calling us, let's go.
आणि तुझी हरकत नाही आहे ना, तर मी अगदी म्हणजे लगेचच त्यांना होकार देऊन टाकला. म्हटलं हो, आपण परत जाऊया.
मला असं वाटत होतं की यावंच त्याने.
So it was what you might like to call as an intuitive decision. A lot of my decisions have been intuitive.
He put aside personal gains and came back to India as the head of NCL. National Chemical Laboratory, Pune, the brainchild of Sir Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar, first Director General of CSIR in 1942. 5 years later, on April 6, 1947, the foundation stone was laid by the then Chief Minister of Mumbai, Sri B.G. Kher. The purpose of this laboratory is to advance knowledge and to apply chemical sciences for the good of the people, is the motto of NCL. The Premier Institute was built with generous funds donated by many Indian industrialists. The work of NCL began in biochemistry, chemical engineering, inorganic chemistry, plastic and polymers. The first Director General of the Institute was J.W. Maxwell. 7 deputy heads were then nominated for the 7 subsections of NCL. In 1965, Dr. B.D. Tilak was nominated as the Director of NCL, and it was during this time that the institution grew in leaps and bounds. In 1989, Dr. Raghunath Mashelkar took over the reins of this organization.
National Chemical Laboratory is one of the greatest laboratories in this particular field in the world, very prestigious laboratory. The role of a director of a National Chemical Laboratory has been actually donned by very, very eminent people who have been great chemists, chemical technologists, chemical engineers, like Dr. Venkatraman, Dr. Tilak, Dr. Doraiswamy, who was my predecessor. So to step in to that was, I would say, a very great honor indeed. Rather than doing reverse engineering or copying, we had to do forward engineering so that our products could be better than the best that the multinationals could produce. That was one change. Secondly, we had done scientific research, but many times we did not link it to industry research. Our understanding of the market was poor. Our understanding of the customers was poor. And it was becoming sort of very evident that in this era of competition, you had to run faster than your competitor.
Ramesh and I came to in fairly close contact when he was the director of the National Chemical Laboratory in Pune. And he was, as is well known, one of the most successful directors of the National Chemical Laboratory when the interest of industry in research grew enormously, primarily due to Ramesh's advocacy of the role of R&D in improving industrial competitiveness. It was Ramesh's initiative that first brought companies like General Electric and DuPont to collaborate with Indian scientists at NCL in Pune, and that laid the foundation of the subsequent avalanche of collaboration of foreign companies with laboratories in India, ranging from the CSIR to IITs and the other universities.
The greater challenge was because in 1991, India opened up. We talked about liberalization, opening our trade to other countries and so on and so forth. And that issue of liberalization as well as globalization that was setting up put up a huge challenge for laboratories like National Chemical Laboratory, which had actually functioned in the era of protection. and suddenly that protection was taken out. So I believe that was probably my greatest challenge when I took over.
In 1941, an idea was born that would culminate in a chain of laboratories enabling science to play its proper role in the economic development of the country. In 1942, the Council of Scientific and Industrial Research was born. Dr. Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar was the first director.
Well, CSIR is a chain today of 38 laboratories. It has around 22,000 people. Out of which around 6,000 are scientists and around 4,000 technical support people. We exist from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. For example, we have a National Chemical Laboratory, we have a National Botanical Research Institute, National Physical Laboratory, National Aerospace Laboratory. So depending upon the different areas, we have laboratories. We also have laboratories like Indian Institute of Petroleum, Central Food Technology Research Institute, Central Building Research Institute. So they impinge on petroleum, building, food, etc. Basically what we do is that we develop technologies, transfer them to industry, re-productionizes it, and the goods reach people. Our basic mandate is to make India strong in its technological capacity.
I have had an occasion to meet with him several times. The cause of the pharma industry is very close to him. For he realizes that this is one industry where intellectual capital is plentiful and India can make a mark for itself in the world. He's gone out of the way to help the industry in trying to harness science, which is from CSIR, to industry, in trying to harness government resources and government help to promote research and development in the pharmaceutical industry.
For the first time in a publicly funded institution, someone was talking in terms of defining quantitatively and promising well in advance, 5-6 years in advance, that this is what we are going to achieve. All the 40 laboratories at that time, now we are 38, at that time 40, had behaved as though they were 40 laboratories. Now suddenly we started talking in terms of being a CSIR incorporated, one entity where all of us we are going to contribute and make sure that we reach that particular goal. I believe that was a huge change.
Dr. Mashelkar had received many accolades on different international fronts. However, the common man came to know of him after his fight against turmeric patent.
Oh yes. Now what one suddenly found was that although the knowledge was ours, you were seeing some American patents on that. What does American patent means? That means America claims that they have discovered this. Now that cannot be right. I mean, if you look at turmeric, wound healing properties of turmeric. These are known to my mother, so they must be known to my mother. How can America take patents on that? So therefore, when this particular patent appeared, I said, nothing doing. We have to challenge. We have to demonstrate that this is India's traditional knowledge. Nobody else can have a right on that. And we fought it, and within 14 months we won. And I believe that was a path-breaking event because it opened up the eyes of the entire world that you can't take the developing world for granted. They also know how to fight. And most importantly, we knew how to win because, you know, we have lost that habit of winning. So this was important. But these three battles which India has fought, turmeric, neem and basmati, has helped enormously in one, India understanding the importance of this and also India having a confidence that if we fight, we can win and how to fight. Secondly, the Western world has understood that they can't take us for granted and therefore now new systems are coming where our traditional knowledge will be put on par with other systems of knowledge like industrial property systems. This was not happening in the past. So the entire patent classification system is getting changed now across the world. And this all happened because we took that first little step called Haldighati Ki Ladai.
He has authored 19 books, 240 research-based theses, and has been granted doctorate by 14 different universities from India and abroad. Dr. Mashelkar was awarded with many time-honored awards like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Medal, Vishwakarma Medal, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru National Award, among others. He has a strong bond with this soil and culture. FRS, Fellow of the Royal Society. He is the third Indian engineer to be granted this internationally acclaimed recognition.
The Royal Society was formed in 1668. So it is more than 3 century old sort of organization. And there have been great people who have been fellows of Royal Society. You know, all the things that you read in textbooks, like Hooke, Boyle, Newton, etc., etc. You know, they were all fellows of Royal Society. So what happens is that in that actual function, when they make you a fellow of Royal Society, you are given an opportunity to see the other fellows who have signed in the book. And by the way, when you sign in the book, you do it in the same way as they did centuries ago. That means you have to use ink and so on and so forth. And you should make sure that you don't spoil a page and so on. So we go through a lot of practice. And the most thrilling moment was they ask you to see any, let us say, anybody's signature. And I chose to see Newton's signature, which is a small signature on page 9, basically. And it's a thrilling feeling to sign in the same book that Newton has signed. I think that is the greatest moment of my life.
Any organization is built on the strength of its leadership. During the 1998 Padma Prize ceremony, I had commended the role played by Dr. Mashelkar in giving a new vision to CSIR. We facilitate him today for completing 25 years of distinguished service to CSIR.
He is a teacher and a loving father.
He was always a father when he came back from office at home. We would play cricket together, go out, you know, for lunches and dinners. So it was a very different role that he played at home. We never felt like, you know, he's probably the director of NCL or director general of CSIR. He was always a father to us. And in that context, I think he played his roles as a father very well.
बराच अभ्यास घेत असत मुलांचा. आमची मुलंही तशी होती, स्वतःहून बसत नसत अभ्यासाला.
रागीट नव्हता काय असं समजून सगळे. आतापर्यंत त्याने कधी रागावला नाही आहे, कधी मी सांगितलेलं त्याला पटतं पण अजूनपर्यंत. कळलं का? तसं आमचं काय हे नाही होतं. अमेरिकेत गेला तरीसुद्धा आमचं दोघांचं पत्रव्यवहार 8-8 दिवस आमचं ठरवूनच टाकलं होतं की माझा 8 दिवसात त्याला पत्र जायचं, त्याचा 8 दिवसात पत्र मला यायचं.
पण घरात तसं आम्ही सगळीजणं एकमेकांच्या मताने सगळं करतो, पण कुठे काही अडचण आली की आम्हाला त्यांची गरज भासतेच.
वेल, आय बिलीव्ह इन लॉर्ड गणेशा. वी सेलिब्रेट गणेश चतुर्थी. आय मीन, ही कम्स होम फॉर 5 डेज अँड दोज 5 डेज आर फॅन्टॅस्टिक. अवर एंटायर फॅमिली gets together during that time, and there are aartis and so on. Some of them last for 1 hour, by the way. We invite on the 4th day. We do some major puja, and this has gone on for decades now in my family.
He knew at that time that I had fancy for Marks and Spencer shirts. So every time he'll come from England, he'll bring one Marks and Spencer shirt for me. I was very touched by his recollection.
तुम्हाला सांगितलं तर एखाद्या वेळेला आश्चर्य वाटेल की तो विद्यार्थी असताना त्याने एक सुंठी वाचून खोकला गेला असं एक छोटंसं नाटुकलं लिहिलं होतं. त्याच्यात काम केलं होतं आणि मला वाटतं दिग्दर्शनही त्यानेच केलेलं असं.
आय माय सेल्फ यूज टू राईट ड्रामाज. For example, one of them was Sunti Vasun Khokla Gela. It was supposed to be a mystery drama, you know. And I remember writing it, acting in it, directing it. And I still remember that I was so busy in directing and correcting others that I forgot my own dialogues. And I had to recreate some dialogues while I was on the stage.
Jeva dabba mi college madhe pathvayachi. आणि घाईघाई सकाळचे मुंबईत म्हणजे असं की 8 वाजता 9 वाजता डबेवाले येतात. घाईघाईत स्वयंपाक करायचा आणि द्यायचा. कधी मीठ विसरायची, कधी काय हळद विसरायची, पण त्याला काहीच माहिती पडायची. अरे आज भाजी कशी झाली आल्या विचार छान झाली होती. पण मी दुपारी जेवायला बसते तेव्हा मला कळायचं की ह्याच्यात मी मीठ घातलेलं नाही.
आय डोंट हॅव पर्टिक्युलर चॉईसेस. आय डू लाईक गोयानीज फूड बाय द वे. इन फॅक्ट आय एम लेट अस से सो नॉन डिस्क्रिमिनेटिंग अबाउट फूड दॅट माय वाईफ अँड माय मदर ऑलवेज हॅव कंप्लेन दॅट यू कॅन सर्व हिम एनिथिंग and he will not notice it. So as to say,
he does things with commitment. If he came to wedding or he came for some function like my felicitation function, he took lot of interest, participated. There was a song composed on me in which he was one of the singers.
I like music. I like classical music. I don't understand much of it. For example, listen to classical music practically every day. In fact, normally I don't go to bed before 11:30, 12. But when I go to the bed, the CD will be in and I'll be listening to it. I don't know when it will basically stop. But it brings you, let us say, closer to God.
He communicates so well that he instantaneously resonates with a person. No matter whether he's peon or he's chief minister or he's a prime minister, or he has that knack of perceiving what the other person likes and how to communicate with that person.
If one were to ask me, as to you were to be born again, what would you like to do? What journey you would like to take? I don't mind taking that journey again at all. Exactly the same institution that I served, the same family that I had. I would not want anything other than that.
दोन नाती आहे, एक नातू आहे, कळलं का? तर सगळे माझे विचारपूस करतात, पाहिजे नको बघतात, सगळं मुलगा पण सगळं व्यवस्थेची हे करतो. एकदम समाधानी आहे माझ्या. मला वाटतं की माझ्यासारखे जगात सुखी कोणी नाही.
पीपल कॉल मी अ डेंजरस ऑप्टिमिस्ट, बट आय बिलीव्ह इन इंडिया. आय डू बिलीव्ह इंडिया वॉज अ ग्रेट नेशन अँड इंडिया इज गोईंग टू बी अ ग्रेट नेशन इन दिस कमिंग मिलेनियम. 21st सेंचुरी जस्ट द फर्स्ट चॅप्टर ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर मिलेनियम. One of the greatest thing about India is its demographic advantage. Whereas the rest of the nations like America, Europe, Japan are getting older, we will continue to be young. And therefore there is a power of the youth which has to be utilized. But that youth has to be one which believes in itself, the self-confidence. It believes in India. If these two things are carried forward by the youth, I think there is nothing that an Indian mind cannot achieve.
अथांग सागर किनाऱ्या लगत नाव एक त्यांची होती डोलत. बुरसटलेल्या उभ्या आडव्या बांबूंनी जोडलेली ठिगळांच्या चांदण्याची नक्षी काढलेली चिरिछिद्रातून शेकडो कारंजे फुलविलेली शेवाळ्याचा हिरवा मऊ मऊ गालीच्या पांघरलेली. अथांग सागर किनाऱ्या लगत नाव एक त्यांची होती डोलत. सहा तपे परिश्रमाचा खडतर प्रवास केला अजूनही हुरूप कायम उरून राहिला. मात्र होऊन आज तो दीपस्तंभ अथांग सागर किनाऱ्या लगत नाव एक त्यांची होती डोलत.